낙태가 한국에서는 거의 범죄고, 다만 현실적으로는 처벌을 안 하는 상황인데, 이 법이 그 위헌이라고 결정이 날 경우에 어떤 형태의 법을 만들지는 아직 안 정해진 상태입니다. 예를 들어서 미국처럼 12주까지는 완전히 자유롭게 그 로브의 웨이드처럼 갈지, 혹은 낙태를 허용하는 다른 사유들을 만들지, 그런 모델들을 검토를 해야 되는데, 헌법재판소에서 만약에 위헌 결정을 하게 되면 기간을 정하고, 한 2년 정도 기간을 정하고 그때까지 법을 만들라고 할 겁니다. 어떤 모델을 추천할 수 있는지 그런 말씀을 해주시면 도움이 되겠네요.
That's a great question. I'm glad you asked it. I think the whole point of having the joint parliamentary committee that looked at the issue of legal models was to look at the best practice that exists internationally and what the highest standards are. So in some ways we were quite lucky being one of the last countries to legislate for abortion because we could look at the mistakes the other countries had made and avoid those. So it became very clear to us from looking at the international evidence that grounds-based laws, so focusing just on grounds of, say, health or in cases of rape,
Ground-based law.
they don't generally work. They work in later pregnancy, but for early pregnancy, it has to be made more accessible. So interestingly, this is what the international human rights framework also supports. So UN human rights experts came out in 2016 in the middle of our campaigning work, and they said that the best way to ensure access to abortion, the best practice found in many countries, is access to abortion on request in the first trimester of pregnancy or in early pregnancy, and then afterwards on in exceptional circumstances such as cases of rape, incest, fetal impairment, or a risk to health or life. So that's broadly what we adopted. We also noted that internationally, having a lot of requirements for women to qualify where there's a risk to health or in cases of rape acts as a barrier. So, in cases of rape, that what's recommended is just that the woman self declares what she's been through and then is not questioned or required to go to the police. And of course, in cases of, risk to health, because there's so much risk involved, to ensure that there aren't a lot of barriers she has to go through in order to obtain access. So that is practice that we've looked at. That's roughly the basis for our law. There are some ways in which our law falls short of international human rights law. For example, there's a 3-day waiting period.
You have 3-day waiting queue.
Which is not, it's there's no medical basis for it, and it creates a real barrier, say, for poor women, maybe who can't take the time off work or can't attend to appointments. So there are a few issues with the law that still need to be ironed out for it to be perfectly human rights compliant, but broadly, it adheres.
That's great. 그 혹시 스파우스의 컨센트가 이슈가 되지는 않는지 한번 물어봐 주세요. 그러니까.
Issues about consent of spouse?
No, so there's no requirement for spousal consent. I think Ireland had spousal consent laws for contraception. That would have been like in the 1970s. Those would have been gone in the 1980s.
그거는 전혀 문제가 안 되는 거네요.
But many it's not required by law, but we know from evidence that many women involve their partners in the decision making where that partner is supportive. Of course, in a situation of, say, domestic violence, they might not involve their partner, but usually where there's a supportive relationship, they will anyway.
미성년자가 임신했을 경우에 부모의 동의를 받아야 된다, 뭐 이런 식의 다른 배리어가 있는지.
Issues about teenager case? Is there like a parent's consent or some other adult?
Yeah, this was yeah, this made up a part of the discussions the parliamentarians had about this issue. Irish law is a bit complicated when it comes to adolescents and young people mm-hmm. because there's one age of sexual consent and a different age mm. of medical consent. Mm. So it's not exactly clear whether you have to involve a parent or guardian. Mm. But there's laws, I know Ireland is not part of the UK anymore, mm. but there's a law in the UK, it's a guideline that says if the young person is not being coerced, mm. If they're going to engage in a risky behavior, whether or not you provide them with services, then you can provide them with those services. Mm. So some Irish doctors go by that guidance, mm. even though it doesn't have a basis in Irish mm. law. But it says, for our abortion law, it says in the medical guidelines that in exceptional circumstances, mm. Doctors can provide abortions for adolescents without parental consent. Mm. Of course, they should always try and involve the parents, mm. but if it's a situation of incest, mm. if the parents mm-hmm. are trying to coerce the child mm-hmm. to have the pregnancy against their will, mm. then the doctor can take the child's best interest into account and act on their wishes.
Mm. 참고로 그 저기 저 그 나이 기준이 몇 살인가요? 아까 두 가지 뭐 여러 가지.
I mean, is it the same?
다르다고, 아니 그게 아니라 다르다고 하셨는데
For sexual consent for girls and girls?
Sexual consent and medical consent, what is the age?
I believe the age of sexual consent is 17, mm. 17. I think, mm. and medical consent is 16. And the age of sexual consent, I think, used to be different for girls and boys, but it's now the same.
Yeah. 본격 소셜 정치 미디어 금태섭 TV.